Today we're going to talk about identifying growth markets for your business. In business, we're all looking for ways to increase sales and in turn profits from those sales. One of the best ways for any business to do this is to appeal to a broader range of people and companies. Well, how do you find these markets commonly referred to as growth markets? Well, it's really simple, but first you need to have a common understanding of market demand. Market demand is quickly defined as what our customers want to buy. This is usually the biggest indicator for potential growth for your business to investigate or invest in. Things such as new garment trends, like dry wicking fabric or form-fitting clothing, or new garment fads or niches like affliction or comedy t-shirts, new decorating techniques that are more readily available like rhinestones or spangle, new local sports teams or existing teams that are finding new success, new sports leagues starting up, lacrosse, soccer, t-ball, any new businesses that are in the area, trade show or conventions that are coming to town. These are all great leading indicators of current or near future growth markets. Now we need to identify the different categories these growth markets could fall into our business. There are two main categories for growth markets: new customers and existing customers. New customers, of course, those are new people or businesses that I need to spend more time and money to reach. Existing customers are people or companies I'm already doing business with on a regular basis or have done business with in the past. In part one of this article, we'll review how to broaden our appeal to our existing customers. So let's take a look at them. First thing we should talk about with customers we're already doing business with is how can we get them to spend more for the same thing. To accomplish this, we have to think outside the box. Offering a new placement location for embroidery or adding digital printing or screen printing are just a couple of those ideas. Everyone's seen the standard left chest logo, but don't forget there's more places on a shirt to put a logo. Look at areas like the sleeve cuff for logos and names, shirt placket for initials, or the back of the collar or back of the yoke for websites. And now that we have more places to put logos, let's get into multiple placements with our customers. You almost have to promise yourself you're not going to sell that standard 7-ounce polo with just that simple left chest logo for $16.95. Now you have to sell it with two cuffs and a placket initial for $27.95. Same shirt, three additional hoopings, that's $11 additional selling price, and it results in a higher ticket value with that customer and higher profits. What about updating a logo for your customer? The trend to more business casual wear and longer working days leaves employees meeting friends and family right after work for a drink or for dinner. Tone-on-tone logos allow that employee to go out without feeling like a billboard for their company, and it saves time so they don't have to go home and change first. This new styling gives you a great talking point with your customers and an opportunity to look at new apparel options with a fresh-looking logo for them to promote. You know, when's the last time you sat down with some of your biggest customers and talked about their apparel needs and how you can help fill those needs? Remember, the customer doesn't really care about your business, but they do care about what your business can do to help them. Whether you've been an apparel decorator for 15 minutes or 15 months or 15 years, that's more experience than you have over your customer, so use it. Be the expert, make recommendations, and discourage poor quality items. If you have other items your customers like or are buying, show them off. Create demand within your market. Take some of those new samples in with you on your visits. Look professional. Remember, you are the decorating expert. The more your customers come to rely on you for your apparel knowledge and expertise, the more they're likely to be repeat customers. In any business today, diversification is almost required. Look at some of the largest and most successful retailers in the world, and you'll see a common theme: one-stop shopping. We all know the gigantic retailers out there, and the reason why they do so well is convenience. You can buy everything in one place. You know, we're all busy as business owners, employees, parents, volunteers. We want to get everything that we need, from toothpaste to cold cuts to the latest DVDs, all in one place to save us time. Because why? Time is money. Our decorated apparel customers are no different. Our customers want to be able to get their t-shirts, their jackets, hats, blankets, towels, signs, vehicle wraps, business cards, trophies, pens, you name it. They want to get it all in one place. In fact, the companies that offer multiple decorating or embellishing techniques have a faster return on their overall business with each new decorating technique they add to their business because of a broader appeal they have to a broader market. So when it comes to our customer base, Reaching out to them for new types of orders with new decorating techniques is the easiest way to grow your business. Stay tuned for part two of Identifying Growth Markets in our next newsletter. Thanks for listening, and remember to visit swfeast.com for our newsletter archives full of more marketing videos and helpful articles to help you grow your business. Thanks again.